Well, from this visit, I remember the one showcase displaying two items, a handbag and a cap made with strange fabric. The fabric seemed to present a dot polka pattern. For me, it was difficult to see if it was printed or painted by hand. And since that moment, I came almost every 2 years to the museum when I had the occasion to visit Saigon. And I was still obsessed by the process of making this pattern. So then I started to ask the museum if they had any idea. So it happened that the staff in the museum, they didn't know anything about these two objects. And even the conservator of the museum who made this exhibition passed away. So I had to understand by myself how these two objects were made. I was impressed by the composition of the pattern. I wanted to use it myself to make some canvases. And I like the idea of recycling equipment from wartime. It goes with the idea of the 70s, peace and love. It goes with the hippie ideas. I like to play with this kind of way of thinking. I was playing with boots belonging to some GI soldiers and some helmets. And I was just like putting dirt into the shoes and the helmets, and I was growing plants inside. For me, these objects, they were like, it was some sculpture, but you could see some reincarnations of dead soldiers or something like that. And later, luckily, I've been very lucky because I was showing the picture of the cap and the handbags made of bulletproof jackets, American bulletproof jackets. I've been lucky because the people I met, they knew it was made from American equipment, but they didn't know much. And one day I went to a market asking everywhere if people, they know how to get this kind of objects, and I did not find anyone to help me. And luckily one day I saw a tote bag hung on the top of a stand, and I bought it and then started the project. When I'm thinking of making a canvas, I see the structure as a skeleton, and I see the fabric stretched on the structure as a skin. So for me, a canvas, a painting, is like a body, because it's a good way to recycle the leftovers. You see many people in the market, they recycle all the pieces of fabric from different colors to make like a larger piece and cover their stands or whatever. The scale of the material is limited because it's from a jacket. So if you want to go to a larger scale, you have to, you know, assemble it and use the patchwork technique. I'm thinking of the Japanese artist Yayoi Kusama. Also, I'm also thinking of the Swiss painter John Armleder. But in the composition, you can see the grids, and I'm familiar to Mondrian. Sometimes you have some stains. It makes some kind of color fields, and I'm thinking of Mark Rothko. In some composition, I'm thinking of Paul Klee. There are many artists I have in mind when I'm working, and it does not come from nothing, from nowhere. And for me, this kind of work, I try to put myself in the shoes of the people who were there. And also, when you have the material in your hands from the time, you can realize that they are proof of the history, and you have, when you manipulate them, you are connected to the history in a way. Yes, when you work on a bigger scale, you can project yourself, but not also not something visual. It's also something about the body. And when it's something smaller, the projection is something more intimate. And I like to explore different possibilities with different scales. I think I answered earlier referring to Mondrian, Rothko, Paul Klee, John Armleder, but I can also speak about Olivier Mossé, who was my mentor, and I had the chance to work for him as an assistant. And this artist started his career painting just one cycle in the middle of a white canvas. Yeah, they are more paintings than ready-made, but they are made with ready-made materials. We could speak about ready-made painting, but there is still the use of the patchwork technique, so it's not clear to say it's ready-made or painting. I think it's in between. It's a good question. I think I want to make something close to abstract painting, but also close to craft. It's really like at the limit in between.